primary cause of things. Let us begin with how something came about, why it came about in that particular way, and became what it is. For me, it begins in Vienna in 1819.
Mom?
But for me, it begins with a music publisher by the name of Anton Diabelli.
Mom?
This music publisher has written the small waltz that will change everything.
Mom?
What is it?
Have you heard a word I said?
Yes.
What did I say?
You said that they'll call us in soon.
No, I said that everyone else who's here before us has gone in, so we're next.
We've been here for 2 hours.
I know, we're next. Do you need anything?
No, thank you. I'm fine. I need to be back to the office by 3.
You'll make it.
Don't you have to be at work?
I told them I'd be late.
You can leave, Clara. I've done this plenty of times before.
Here, let me help you with that.
No, thank you. I'm fine. I can do it myself.
Hello there. So sorry about the delay.
It's been 2 hours.
Yes, I'm very sorry it's been a madhouse here today.
Wait, who are you?
Mike.
Well, where's Gary?
It's his day off. He got me today.
Are you a doctor?
No, I'm a nurse.
But he'll just be administering the tests, right?
Yeah, I'll only do the tests.
He'll only do the tests. Okay.
So you must be Catherine Brandt.
No, I'm Dr. Brandt.
Oh, okay. Well, come this way, please.
Thank you.
Oh, excuse me. I'll have to wait here.
Well, I'd like to come in with her.
No, we're going to examine her, so we better stay here.
Well, just so you know, because my mother's not going to tell you. She wants to travel in a week.
But why wouldn't I tell him? I tell him I am traveling in a week.
To Bonn.
Where's that?
In Germany,
which is in Europe.
Thank you. Well, I don't see any problem with it right now. I mean, you look fine to me, so let's see what these show. When was your last visit?
4 months ago.
Apparently she was told she had to come every 2 months.
She looks fine to me.
I really think she should postpone her trip to Bonn a bit, don't you think?
I'm a nurse. Not a travel agent.
Can I please speak to you for a moment in private?
I don't think so. Look, your mother is my patient, not you.
You know what? Go ahead. Otherwise, we'll be here all day. I begin my search in Vienna in 1819. The world is poised to enter the modern era. A Schubert, Beethoven, Liszt, and Czerny are all composing new works. But amidst all this, one event captures my imagination more than all the others. A music publisher by the name of Anton Diabelli extends an invitation.
An invitation to the 50 greatest composers in Vienna. My dear musicians, I'm enclosing in this letter a new waltz of my making.
He was a great music publisher, but not so great a composer.
I composed it but a few days ago, and I wish to invite each of you to compose one variation on my theme. Once I receive the variations, I will publish them all in one handsome volume that I promise will be a very beautiful and popular book.
He knew it would sell well. After all, for the price of one book, the music lover gets 50 compositions by the best composers in Vienna.
I hope you will find in my waltz a very worthy and inspiring theme.
All of whom would have immortalized Diabelli's tiny waltz.
And of course, I will compensate each of you for the variations that you contribute. I eagerly await your reply. Yours sincerely, Anton Diabelli, music publisher of the firm Diabelli, Copy and Company.
All the composers went to work on variations of Diabelli's less-than-stellar waltz. All the composers except one.
Dear Signor Diabelli, the master has received your charming and melodic waltz, along with the request for him to write one variation on it.
Beethoven took one look at the waltz and hated it.
Although this project is a very intriguing proposition and the master is very curious about it, at this time he is inundated with other commissions.
According to Anton Schindler, a biographer and close associate of Beethoven, he called it a Schusterfleck, a cobbler's patch. He found it commonplace.
So he must regretfully decline your very kind invitation.
Thank you very much.
Sincerely,
yours truly,
Beethoven's loyal servant,
etc., etc.,
on the Holz.
But then something happened to Beethoven.
What? What? What do you mean?
History doesn't record what he said.
But I already told him, are you certain? Fine. Fine! Signor Diabelli. The master has asked me to come see you in person. I will be in your offices tomorrow at 3:00. Until then, I remain most sincerely yours, Beethoven's loyal servant, Anna Hans.
Beethoven changed his mind and became obsessed with the waltz. He devoted the next 3 years of his life to it. He did not write one variation on it. Instead, he wrote 33. His longest piece for solo piano, and what many consider to be the most important work in variation form. This obsession of Beethoven baffles me. What was it about this insignificant waltz that so captured his imagination? I mean, at this point in his life, Beethoven is only tackling major works. He has very little time left. Yet, he chooses this insignificant waltz as his next project. Why? I'll be leaving for Bonn in a little over a week, and there at the Beethoven archives, I'll have access to his sketchbooks and his diaries. I have to understand why a genius became obsessed with mediocrity.
I'm ready for you, Dr. Grant.
Who won?
He did. I'll wait here.
Are you sure we can't call Gary?
Yes, but if it makes you feel any better, you can call me Gary.
Great, a funny nurse. Colleagues there. Did it make you uncomfortable the way he kept looking at you?
Please, that nurse?
Yes, that nurse. He was looking at you.
Mom, no, he wasn't.
You know, in the exam room, he kept asking me questions about you.
Mom!
You took him 15 minutes to find my vein.
Mom, I'm pretty sure he knew what he was doing.
He dropped my urine sample. Yeah, you should date that guy. I mean, he fits the profile of your last 3 boyfriends.
Mom, maybe I should come with you.
What about Hedda Gobbler?
My costumes are all done, and my assistant can take it from here. Besides, I've been looking into a few of the things, and I'm thinking of apprenticing as a set designer. What?
I don't know, Clara. I thought you liked being a costume designer.
I do.
You can't excel at anything if you keep changing careers.
I excel at changing careers.
Yeah, that's a brilliant idea. You know, that way you'll always be mediocre at everything.
What happens if you fall? What happens if you get weaker?
I'm not on my deathbed.
Look, I never said you were.
No, but you're acting like it.
Okay, I'm sorry. It's just, I don't understand why you can't do your research here. I mean, when you wrote your book on Mozart, you didn't fly off to Vienna.
Because Mozart composed in his head, a Beethoven composed on paper, so there are thousands and thousands of his sketches, his every compositional idea. And they're in Bonn. I have to go.
Is this really how you want to spend this time?
How else?
Signor Diabelli, The master has decided he doesn't want to write one variation on your waltz.
Yes, so you said.
Now he's considering writing a set of several variations on it.
What?
Yes, Signor. Wharton smiles upon you.
A set of variations?
That's what he asked me to tell you.
What wonderful news! And how many variations did he have in mind?
6 or 7.
Oh, that many?
Indeed.
But, Anna, I'm confused. Yesterday he said he didn't have time to write one variation. Today he says he wants to write 7. Why did the master change his mind?
God only knows his reasons. But there you are.
That's wonderful. We would love to publish 7 variations by Beethoven. It may even merit his own book.
It certainly will. Of course, an undertaking of this magnitude will take many hours of work.
Yes.
Which the master will be devoted to your waltz.
Oh, yes, what an honor.
And he will be doing all of this for only 80 ducats.
80 ducats?
In advance.
In advance?
Yes.
We can't take that kind of risk.
Risk? You're speaking of Beethoven. What is the risk?
Beethoven has composed nothing of a note in the last 5 years.
How dare you?
It's not me. The people are talking.
And what are the people saying?
That he's finished. That he has nothing more to offer. That he's too ill.
People love to speak of other people's maladies. It makes them feel healthy.
Is any of it true?
It is no secret that Beethoven has been ill.
People who have seen him say he looks like a madman. A beggar. We can't just give you 80 ducats and not get a composition in return. That could ruin us.
Signor Diabelli, it is 6 or 7 variations. And your waltz, your composition, will give birth to a beautiful set of variations by Beethoven.
You will have 40 ducats now, and 40 ducats when the work is finished.
I will tell the master.
Number 16, please come to the counter. Number 16.
That's me, thank you.
Excuse me? What number do you have?
Oh, 17. What about you?
34. Have you been waiting long?
What day is this?
Oh, no.
Oh, yes. What, in a hurry?
Yeah, I'm going to get my mom's laptop fixed. She's going on a trip. Are you waiting to get your computer fixed?
Yeah, my laptop. Apparently you're not supposed to drop.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, no, it's actually kind of nice change. Usually when I come here, I pay $150 for them to tell me to press Control-Alt-Delete.
Well, I'm a Mac girl myself, so...
Ooh, I see. Well, we're from totally different worlds then. It would have never worked out between us. Sorry. Oh my god, you don't remember me, do you? I examined your mom at the hospital.
Oh, yeah! I'm sorry. That was a rough day.
Yeah, well, how is she?
She's the same.
How long has she been ill?
8 months, but she just told me 2 weeks ago. She didn't want to worry me. And she's still taking that trip to Bonn.
Is that in Germany?
Yes. Sorry.
Well, she's a courageous woman.
She has to finish her monograph.
Wait, a autograph?
It's a book she's writing. She's been invited to present a very important paper on it at the end of the month.
Oh, well, good for her. You know, most people, when they're diagnosed, they just want to stay home and spend time with the family. Oh, I'm sorry. That's not what I meant.
My mother.
Ah.
We don't have that kind of relationship. She has to finish her monograph.
Oh.
I'm sorry. It was Dr...
Mike. No doctor. I'm a nurse.
Right. Clara.
Hi. Are you a scholar, too?
Me, no. I'm a costume designer at the moment, but I'm on my way to becoming a set designer. I'm gonna be here all day, aren't I?
Yes, you are.
Kind of makes the way to the hospital seem not so bad.
Touché.
Number 17, please come to the counter. Number 17.
Yeah, that's me. Do you want my number?
Your number?
17.
Oh, no, I can't do that.
Please, I have more time than your mother. No, I mean that she has to catch a plane. You know what I mean.
Thank you. Thank you.
Morgen, meine Damen und Herren, und willkommen auf dem Lufthansa, Flug 805, nach Bonn. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome again to Lufthansa Flight 805 to Bonn. We've now reached our cruising altitude of 35,000 feet. The captain has turned off the seatbelt sign, indicating it is safe to move out the cabin. This is variation number one. In it, Beethoven instructs the pianist with the words, "Alla marcia maestoso," to be played in the style of a majestic march. And I find it fascinating that Beethoven begins his exploration of Diabelli's waltz with a majestic march. Perhaps he's instructing us. When beginning a great voyage, one must set aside trepidation and doubt. Even if we may not yet know where the journey will take us, we must nevertheless embark on it with courage and determination, as though it were a majestic march. If you look out your window now, you may see some beautiful landscapes of the German countryside. You may be able to see the woods where Beethoven composed some of his best work. Early in May of 1822, the master traveled to the village of Hetzendorf, where he rented a beautiful home and spent the summer there composing. The first compositions he undertook there was the variations on Diabelli's waltz, which had taken his fancy in a curious way. Phrase in Schumer's biography. Diabelli's waltz had taken his fancy in a curious way. How had it taken his fancy? In what way was it curious? Schumer's biography doesn't elaborate on that. In no time at all, he composed five variations, then five more, then two more. Every morning before dawn, he was at his desk. The variations kept piling up, and he kept saying,
"That's not all. There are more variations in here."
But Master Diabelli is concerned lest the work should go too long and publishing costs too high. He wants him to bring it to a close.
Tell him to be patient yet a little longer.
Master, you should be working on the mass. On a night, why this trifle of a waltz? You've already composed 12 variations on it.
Because there are more variations in here.
You're wasting your time. I'm sorry, but I don't understand this obsession of yours. Signor Diabelli has said he doesn't need any more variations.
I'm not making them for Mr. Diabolus.
You know he doesn't like it when you call him that.
Night and day I toil for the man. So tell him to be patient yet a little longer. I am not finished.
Fine.
In preparation for landing, please fasten your seatbelts. If you've been reading a book about Beethoven, please set it aside, return to the present, and snap out of it. Welcome again to the beautiful city of Bonn. Downtown is exactly as it was in the 1800s, only now there's a statue of Beethoven in the city center. Imagine a town that does not place a military hero in its main square, but a musician. What great promise. Last night I learned that the local delicacy is pig's knuckles. Perhaps that's a part of the city's cultural life I'll have to do without. I'm meeting Dr. Leidenberger tomorrow. At last, I get to see the sketchbooks. I can't wait. Mom. P.S. How's Hedda Gabler? Dr. Kinderman must think highly of you. His recommendation is the only reason you are allowed in here.
Well, it took me over a year to convince him.
Well, only a handful of people are permitted entrance into our archives. It's the most important collection in the world.
I know. That's why I'm here.
Well, your thesis. I'm not sure if our material could be of assistance in your search.
And why not?
But you were trying to find out why Beethoven became obsessed with Diabelli's vaults.
Yes.
Well, it's really a question of inspiration. I do not think our sketches will help you with that.
Well, I won't know until I look then, will I?
But during your visit, I will be with you whenever you are in the library. And I will give you a schedule of when you can come.
Of course.
Come this way. You wanted to see the sketches for the Diabelli variations, yeah?
Yes.
Here they are. Now, many of the sketches for the Diabelli variations are in this sketchbook. All these bare gloves from touching the books. The oil in the fingers can damage the old paper. Are you ready?
Yes.
Here we go. Now this is the Wittgenstein sketchbook. After Beethoven died, they auctioned off sketchbooks. This one was bought and sold many times over the next 130 years. Now, these lines were made in this book almost 200 years ago. He wrote first in pencil, and then he was sure. He went back over it with ink and highlighted the parts he liked.
I see.
This document records his compositional decisions. Some of these phrases have never been played before. Look, this one has never even been recorded. Look here. You are hearing an original composition of Beethoven, never before heard, except by the people who have read this book. And here is what you are looking for. These are some of the sketches for the Diabelli variations.
Nurse Mike?
Yes?
Hi, this is Clara, Catherine Brand's daughter. I hope it's okay I'm calling you on your cell phone.
Of course.
I'm sorry to bother you again. It's just, I'm really confused and I wanted to ask you. I got an email from my mother yesterday filled with typos.
Okay.
You don't understand. My mother doesn't make typos. She just doesn't.
I understand.
I've been trying to read up and learn more, and I've been calling several doctors trying to get more information, but they all keep saying the same thing. Stay the course. What course? I mean, there's no medicine, no treatment, there's nothing. Am I missing something?
Well, they can't tell you anything because we don't have anything. It's an orphan disease.
A what?
Well, there aren't enough patients to interest the pharmaceutical companies into making medications, so there are no drugs coming down the pipeline. Well, there is no pipeline.
So eventually she won't be able to speak anymore.
Well, not necessarily.
And to top it all off, she's in bond.
Listen, I hope this isn't weird or anything, but would you maybe want to meet and get something to eat? So we can talk about your mother and the illness.
Yeah,
and...
yeah, that'd be really helpful. Thank you.
Okay, good. So I'll call you with the details.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
I can't decipher much of his handwriting.
Yeah, it's hard to read. Well, what are you looking for?
Diabelli's vaults.
Ah, yeah. Here it is. Look. The first four bars. And here, you can see all the sketches he made before he arrived at this variation. Now, this is the first sketch he made. Not satisfied with that, he made this. And then, he made this. And here is the variation itself.
Dear Clara, I've been here a little over a week now. I'm making such progress. Today I looked at the sketches for variation number 3. It's a waltz. Diabelli's waltz is clumsy, repetitive, but Beethoven's waltz is so light, so melodious. He begins the waltz on such a light note. But the most interesting part about it, those 3 notes, C, A, B flat. Repeat it over and over again. He's pausing to think. A lesser composer would have changed those bars or erased that passage. But not him. He wants you to see his moment of trepidation, of doubt. And then the notes begin ascending, ascending. A rising promise. Dr. Lederberger, what's this?
Some kind of food stain. It looks like wine.
Wine. It's probably soup. He loves soup.
This soup is terrible. You told me that the soup was good. Does nobody in this household know how to differentiate a tasty bowl of soup from a putrid, rotten, rancid pig straw of stinking swill? Does nobody in this household have a palate? Do I live amongst powerless people?
I didn't know he loved soup.
I didn't either, until I found soup in many of the sketches. You know, these diaries are not only a record of his compositional decisions, but they are also a record of his daily diet. Do you like pig's knees? Pig's knees. It's Vaughn's delicatessen. Oh, the other one all over Europe for our pig's knees.
Pig's knuckles?
Pig's knuckles. But you must try it.
Oh, I don't eat much meat, but
you will like it.
I almost said no, but I felt bad. He already had the tickets. And besides, he's been really good about home. We are both so uncomfortable. God, he probably hates this music. He told me he'd teach me some physiotherapy for mom. He smells good. I can hear him breathing. I wonder if he snores. He has pretty eyes. Oh, the hand. Watch for the hand. That was awkward. There was too much garlic in that pasta. I wish I had a mint. I'm not very good at this.
Right now. It all sounds like classical music to me. Well, I hope she likes it. Is she looking at me? What kind of a face is this? You look like a ball of muscle. Maybe not. Well, that was awkward. What am I doing with my hands? She smells so good. Okay. Hold her hand. Hold her hand. Oh, well, that was something. Oh my gosh, she's holding it back. Best concert ever.
musical city.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm sorry, you're reading.
No, it is okay.
What are you reading?
A book on Mozart.
Mozart? Don't you feel like you're cheating on Beethoven? I mean, looking at the sketches, I almost feel like...
Yeah, well, I remember the night I started.
I had the same feelings.
You are in pain.
No, I'm fine.
What is the problem with the hand?
It's nothing.
I saw you in the library the other day when you tried to pick up the book.
It's nothing.
You don't have to tell me.
Did you follow baseball at all?
Do I look like a woman who follows baseball?
There was a player, Lou Gehrig.
Amyotrophic lateral sclerosis.
How did you know that?
I thought that is what you had. My aunt, 5 years ago, you lost her. It is a beast.
Excuse me?
This train is not coming. It is a beast of our time.
It's been almost a year. I need to publish these variations. My firm needs to publish these variations.
He's not happy with them yet.
What do you mean he's not happy with them?
He won't let you publish them yet. He's not finished.
Please, just give me a date. I think 19 variations is enough. I don't need more. I can publish more.
He can't give you a date.
Why not?
He can't control how many variations there are. The beautiful theme you've composed is the only thing that will determine how many exist in it. When the theme is exhausted, the master will stop.
He mustn't mock me. I don't understand why he's behaving this way.
He is making it better.
Is this why you joined the commission? To mock me?
Signor Diabelli, it is a testament to your composition that the master is finding so much in it.
Please do not flatter me.
I'm telling you the truth. I keep urging him to work on the mass or the night, but he's obsessed with your wants.
Really?
Yes. He returns to that all hours, day and night.
He does?
Yes, Signor Diabelli, he does. Now, if you will pardon me, I must tend to the master.
I think Beethoven is making fun of Diabelli's faults.
Making fun of it?
There's so much humor in the variations. He's mocking the waltz, showing it for all its ineptitude. You can see that with so many of the sketches.
So that's your hypothesis?
Diabelli's waltz is ordinary, and it's mediocre. Beethoven will go on to show Vienna what a masterpiece he can create out of a grain of sand.
I'm not convinced. Oh, by the way, I almost forgot. Your daughter called again.
Thank you.
Are you upset with your daughter?
No, why?
Well, she calls you almost every day. And you don't call her back. Don't you like your daughter? I mean, you love her, of course, but you don't like her, do you?
How can I explain this to you? How can I explain Clara to you? She's like her father. You know, he was a good man and a good father, but he couldn't stick with anything and got mired in mediocrity. And I'm afraid she's like him. First she was a sculptor, and then she was a painter, and then she joined a rock band. I'm afraid my daughter will never truly be anything. I'm afraid my daughter's mediocre.
What? Nothing. Ah, here's our train.
Pictured you in a band.
Well, because you know so much about classical music.
Well,
That's just because my mom started taking me to her music lectures when I was 7.
You were doing a little graduate work when you were 7?
Post-grad. After my dad died, we couldn't afford a babysitter, so I just go with her.
That sounds like fun.
Actually, it was. I loved watching her up there at that podium. I loved seeing the faces of her students. They were so mesmerized. Most kids hate it when their parents work all the time, but I love it because that is when she is at her best. And it kills me that every time she looks at me, all she sees is failure.
Hey, now, if that's all she sees, then your mom's blind. Or maybe she didn't see this.
No.
Oh, yes. Hedda Gabler looks sumptuous and elegant in the new costumes designed by the very talented Miss Clara Brandt. Congratulations.
Thank you. My mother's thrilled I got her rave review in the Village Voice.
My parents are proud of me if I leave the house with pants on. What's the deal?
I don't want to do the same thing for 20 years. I like doing something for a few years, and learning about it, and then moving on. For me, that's a life better lived.
Old school.
Yeah, well, that's how I roll.
No, stop, I can't do this.
We've been doing this for 3 months.
I know, I'm sorry, it's just, I'm all over the place right now, and you, I really like you, and I have a great time with you.
Then what is it?
You're so nice.
Ouch.
And you're so great.
No.
No, it's... My mother's health is deteriorating, and it's only going to get worse, and I don't think you want to be around for that.
I know better than you what I'm getting myself into, and I can help.
I don't want your help. I don't want to be a part of your caseload.
But you're not. Can't you tell I really like you?
Mike, don't say that.
Why not?
Because things between my mother and I are just, they're really difficult right now, and I need to focus on that, okay?
Okay. You do what you gotta do.
Look, I'm sorry. It's just... My mother fell in the library yesterday.
Why didn't you tell me?
She had to be hospitalized for a day.
I'm fine. It was nothing. I'm just a bit tired, that's all.
The hospital called me.
It was nothing. I tripped and fell. I must have been too focused on the work.
Mom!
But Clara, every day I'm making new discoveries, and with Dr. Lindberg's help, I'm maybe done sooner than expected.
That's what she said when I asked her about the episode.
Well, how's Mark?
His name's Mike.
Oh, sorry, Mike.
He's fine.
Mm-hmm.
What?
I don't know, Claire. It's just strange. You're dating a man who saw me naked.
Yeah, and often that's all he ever talks about.
No, Claire, I hope you're seeing other people too.
Yes. Because he saw you naked?
And no, because he's not right for you. You need someone who challenges you.
Mom, why don't you come home? Your doctors are here.
I'm fine, Claire. Really, it was nothing. And... University's threatening to cut my brain in half.
No, you are not fine.
Thank you.
Look, you're ill and you're putting yourself in danger. Mom?
I'm here.
Listen, I was thinking of taking a vacation. I was thinking of going to Europe. Maybe I could come visit with you?
Absolutely not.
Why not?
Look, it's not the right time, Clara.
Well, I want to spend time with you before I have to be your nurse.
You said that to her?
Yeah.
What did she say?
She hung up.
Greet him the way one ought to greet a count.
I was thinking, I didn't notice him.
Master, everyone saw you pull your hat down below your eyes and ignore him. You think that's funny? The Count was humiliated in front of all of his friends. They were all shocked by your behavior.
They want me to be a dancing monkey in their courts! The barons and baronesses, the counts and countesses, there are thousands of them! There's only one Beethoven!
Master, your ears are bothering me, aren't they? Is it the ringing?
That's not what's important. Look, here's what I was thinking about when the man started talking to me.
It's not important.
Who's your face? Come and see this. Look, here's the first trill in Diabelli's waltz, yes?
Yes.
Look what I've done. I've taken these four notes. Played them in this variation.
Nothing's broken, so that's good.
But?
Well, they tried to figure out why she fell. They did a number of tests, but the results are mixed.
Just tell me.
Her forced vital capacity has been reduced by 39% and muscle elasticity by 34%.
In English?
She has to start using a walker, or she's going to hurt herself.
Okay.
And she might need a wheelchair soon.
So the entire schedule they gave me has been a lie.
So what's the result? My doctors are not very optimistic.
They said she'd be able to walk for a few more years. It's been 7 months.
So how long? It's hard to tell. It could plateau and it could stay like this for a while.
I have to know how long she has.
It's hard to tell.
Just tell me.
A year. Maybe a year and a half.
So, are you going home?
Absolutely not.
I have to bring her home.
I must stay here.
She doesn't want to come home. She's told you that.
I don't care. Are you sure?
Yes, I'm staying here.
If I was in your family, I'd want to be with you all the time.
Mike, don't say that.
I can't do it.
Master, please don't say that.
I can't do it.
Master, calm down. This is not the time.
I need more time. Then you should go.
And you should stay.
My mother will kill me.
Sometimes you have to be selfish.
I can't finish these variations. I don't want to get into the set.
I want to come with you.
I can be of help. Signor Diabelli will come for you.
Thank you, but no, I need to go alone.
I need to be alone.
Why?
Because we barely know each other, and that kind of pressure could kill whatever this is.
So there isn't this.
Oh. I learned a few things with my aunt, so I can be of help. I may need some help.
You're gonna need help.
Master, how can I help?
You can't help me. I can't find an ending for the set.
What do you mean you can't find an ending for them yet?
It's all wrong.
This composition is wrong about me. I don't want to end it.
Does he know what he is doing to me?
You're gonna need someone who knows what they're doing.
You have to leave now.
You have to slow down.
Thomas, I can't wait any longer.
I have so much to do.
Please.
How do I convince her?
Listen to me.
You had an opportunity.
You must not lose this opportunity.
This is my last opportunity.
This is my last opportunity.
I can help. Let me help.
Time is there.